And welcome to our April edition of Sports Highlights right here on Cox Cable 47, 517, and NNPSTV.com. Kraig Bikaveras, glad you're with us since February of 1992. Our program airs on Mondays at 7 a.m., 2 p.m., and 7 p.m., weekends at 9 a.m. For more, log on to NNPSTV.com and at Kraig Bik on Twitter. It's G-R-E-G-B-I-C. Our guests today are from the Peninsula Track Club, Jaime Cox and Kraig Cole from the Hampton Cup Regatta. We'll lead off with Jaime, who went to Ferguson. Good to see you.
Nice to see you, Kraig.
So you pretty much grew up here in Newport News.
I did.
How did you get involved in fitness at a young age?
It actually started a little bit later for me. In my 20s, I wanted to get fit, so I started running with my dad. We ran the Rock and Roll Half Marathon together three times, and I just started getting into it that way.
You had a little bit of experience in high school.
Yeah, I ran cross country in ninth grade, but I was like a theater geek, so I didn't really do it after that.
So many opportunities to run and walk in Newport News. Let's just start off before we talk about the track club, the Nolan Trail in Newport News and Newport News Park.
Yes, great places to run. If you want a challenging run, Nolan Trail is the way to go. Hills, you got to be careful out there. Newport News Park is great because it's flat.
Right. Yeah. Now, it seems like more walkers at Nolan Trail, more runners at Newport News Park.
Yeah, Newport News Park has longer distances you can run, whereas Nolan Trail is that strict 5 mile, you know, trail out there.
Yeah, I got to tell you, at one time it seemed like golf and tennis were the popular sports in the spring, but it seems like now there's more marathons year-round, especially this time of the year throughout the entire fall. What is it about marathons that have gotten so popular?
It's just, I think people like to challenge themselves, so it's definitely a challenge. It takes about 5 months of training to do a marathon, and for a spring marathon, you train in the winter, and I think that's much more appealing for people to train in the winter instead of having to train in the summer to do like a fall marathon. They do have marathons all the time, but the spring one is better.
There's a lot of before and after, though, for runners. You can't just get out of the car, get out of your house, and just run. You should stretch and kind of build yourself up, maybe by walking.
Yes, definitely start out walking. You can walk a little bit and then maybe run for like 2 minutes and then walk again and slowly increase your time. And that way you'll be running straight, you know, miles as soon as you've built up that much. But it's definitely good to build up to that, not just to go try to run 5 miles.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. We're talking to Jaime Cox with the Peninsula Track Club. More on that in just a moment. She went to Ferguson High School in Newport News and Christopher Newport. And a lot of times you see people just walking or running in the neighborhoods or on Wark Boulevard or Jefferson Avenue.
Yep, that's my favorite place to run is my neighborhood. Mm-hmm. I live in Hilton. I'll just go when I end up across the Lions Bridge over there, back into actually near this neighborhood to do a long run. I go from Hilton to Hydenwood. You can get a long distance. And it's really pretty run, especially when you get by the water, James River over there.
So when you first heard about the One City Marathon, mm-hmm. last year, and of course they just had one in 2017 recently too. What were your thoughts? That is a pretty big deal. Of course, it's always contingent on weather, but the participation is in the thousands.
Yeah, it was great. The people that run that marathon, I've heard nothing but great things about the people that ran it. I ran it the first 2 years in 2015 and 2016. I didn't run it this year. I needed a little bit of a break from the marathon, but I did run the One City for the first two times that they had it.
Right. Now, how is the Peninsula Track Club involved in that? Were there any people that ran in it?
Lots of our members ran in it, and the Peninsula Track Club, we actually had a water stop at mile 8, so I had to get the volunteers together for that, and we handed out the water and the Gatorade out there, and it was cold this year. The Gatorade actually froze to the table.
Right. At least it didn't snow.
It did not snow, but it was cold.
It was cold. It was early in the morning too.
Yes.
And plus the times just switched.
And that's I thought that was a little bit
Right.
Weird of a, you know, we sprung forward, and but I didn't hear anybody like miss the race or anything because of the time change. But mm-hmm. it was rather odd right. to have it like
the
that.
The one thing about that event, it does put the city in the map. There's a lot of people involved in it. I think there's no perfect time, but Sunday morning is generally the most ideal time for less traffic.
Yes, most marathons do happen on either Saturday or Sunday morning, but Sunday is less traffic, so it is a good time to have one.
We've had your president on here before, Joe, mm-hmm. from the Peninsula Track Club. Talk about the club. How did it get started, and tell us all about it.
It was started in 1955, and it's a running club where we support the local races, so we do all the timing for it. So a race will hire the track club to do the results, so we'll time it, get everything going, and set up the finish line, and we're good for the small race, because if you have like a chip timing company, that's a little more expensive to hire that kind of thing out, whereas the track club's very reasonably priced, and it's not going to take away from their bottom line of any charity that they're running for.
Right, and of course all the Newport News high schools have track and cross country, and it's really a sport that these kids develop at a young age can sustain for a lifetime.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, we've had people been in the track club for years, and whole families will join, and it's just a great club. It's really focused on volunteering, though.
Right. Being involved in the fitness as you are, too, that you know it's not just about exercise, it's about diet as well.
Absolutely.
Especially when you start getting a certain age above 30, you start hearing about watching your sugar intake,
yes.
watching your carbs, you hear more about proteins. What is the ideal diet for anybody?
For anybody, I would just say a balance. You know, don't eat too much. You want to eat mostly vegetables, not too much protein, but you do need it. But definitely lower sugar. Runners tend to have higher carbs, where we eat a lot of carbs because we need that energy. So if you're going to be training for something heavy, you're going to need a little more carbohydrate intake. But you want good carbs, not like donuts and cakes and things like that, which I do love. But,
right.
You know, you
exactly.
want to definitely just moderation, everything in moderation,
right.
I would say.
I believe in that, too. To prepare for a marathon, especially like a marathon over 20 miles, is mm-hmm. a little bit different. That's almost like a full-time job, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. You need, like I said before, at least 5 to 6 months to train. You want to have at least one long run a week. So that's going to take, you know, if you're doing 20 miles, you're talking 3.5 to 4 hours out of your life. So when I trained, I tried to do it during the week so it wouldn't take away from like my family time on the weekend. Not everybody can do that, but if you can, you know, I hear some runners go out like 4 in the morning when it's still dark.
Right.
And you can do that, but it definitely takes dedication.
I don't think there's a perfect time to exercise, but there's never a bad time
never
to exercise.
Never a bad time, nope.
You know, and the thing too is, you know, you talk about walking and running with different marathons, people think it's just long distance. It can be a nice walk as well, correct?
Absolutely. If you just go out and go for a walk 30, 40 minutes a day, I think you're ahead of the game already. You know, you don't want to just be sedentary, especially if you have a office job, things like that. You want to make sure you get out and do some walking or running. And I am a fitness instructor at Sentara Center for Health and Fitness. So if you could come out, do a fitness class, lots of classes. I teach spinning, that's the bike. So that's a great form of cardio mm-hmm. workout.
There's really something for everyone. Walking, swimming, running, they're all great sports, especially this time of the year with such beautiful parks like we mentioned, the Newport News Park and Nolan Trail, or even in your own neighborhood as well. You feel a lot better exercising.
You do, absolutely. I always feel better. And if you exercise in the morning, you burn more calories the rest of the day. So if you
right.
can get that morning workout, it's good.
And that goes hand in hand with your diet, like you said earlier.
Absolutely.
Sometimes if you drink more water, you don't crave that extra side dish or that extra sweet as
yep,
well.
Absolutely.
Yep. Now you talk about some of the events as we're talking right here to the Peninsula Track Club's own Jaime Cox right here. She went to Ferguson and Christopher Newport. What are some of the events upcoming in the late spring and summer that are more popular with the Peninsula Track Club?
With the track club, we have coming up this weekend is the Get Your Rear in Gear 5K. That's at Madison Trail, and we're doing the results for that. The track club's own scholarship race is on April 1st, and that's at Sandy Bottom Nature Park, and that's a big race where we raise money for the scholarship that we give out to the high school students. And then at the end of April is actually the 24-hour ultra run That's at Sandy Bottom Nature Park as well. And George Nelson, who is with the track club, he is the race director for that. And that is a great first ultra. So an ultra is anything beyond a marathon. So we try to see how many miles you can walk or run in a 24-hour period.
Wow.
So it starts at 7 a.m. on April 29th and goes to 7 a.m. on April 30th. And I'm participating in that.
Very good. In what city?
It's in Hampton. It's
okay.
At the Sandy Bottom Nature Park.
All right. Take us behind the scenes of a board meeting that you guys have. How often do y'all meet, and what's a typical meeting like that Joe runs? Tell us all about it.
It's pretty casual. We meet about once a month, and we just talk about upcoming races. There is the Super Grand Prix that's going on between all three running clubs in the area. So it's like a little friendly competition that they have going between all those clubs where you earn points and things like that. And he just, you know, makes sure that the website is up, you know, pictures are up, and it's pretty simple. We always have a general membership meeting where members can come to the meetings, and then there's always, they try to have like a guest speaker that will come and talk at those.
Right. We'll talk about how people can get involved. Talk about social media and your website.
So we're on Facebook. Peninsula Track Club is on Facebook. And we actually have a lot of friends on Facebook for that, over 1,000 for that. And all the information for the races is up on that, the Facebook page. We put pictures up there, and it's pretty simple.
And for your website as well, correct?
Yep. All the races are on the website, so that has all the dates and times of everything. It has pictures from like every race. The results are all up there as well.
And how about membership costs?
It's $25 for a year for just a single person, and then they have like family memberships. Those are $35 for a year, and then we have like 2 year. I think the 2 year is $50, but I'm not 100% on that.
Very good. All right, Jaime Cox with Peninsula Track Club. Thank you so much.
All right, thanks.
And all the best to you and the track club for the spring and summer and the future.
All right, thank you.
Very good. All right, we just learned a lot about track right there. How important it is to exercise and take care of diet and nutrition. Both the physical and emotional go hand in hand. It's important to have a good diet and also a good exercise plan as well in our daily routine. Stay tuned for our next guest as our April edition of Sports Highlights rolls on after this message is all powered by Fazoli's.com.
Fusion Fitness with Alexis. Tune in weekdays 6:30 a.m., Mondays 7:30 a.m., 2:30 p.m., and 7:30 p.m.
And welcome back to our April segment of Sports Highlights right here on NNPSTV.com at Greg Bick on Twitter. Thank you again to Fazoli's as well. Hope you enjoyed our first guest, Jaime Cox from the Peninsula Track Club. It's a pleasure now to talk to Kraig from the Hampton Cup Regatta. Kraig went to Bethel High School. Good to see you, Kraig.
Hey, thanks a lot.
Well, one of your events is the longest ever.
We're the longest continuously running motorsport event of any type in the country. We're American Powerboat Association sanctioned race for Virginia. We're the only one that takes place in Virginia nowadays. We are Region 4 for the APBA region. But what we run, when people think of regatta, they think sailboats. We are not a sailboat race. We are a raw power. We're a power by hydroplane racing. We run everything from flat bottoms or Jersey skiffs to the traditional hydroplane boats people think about when they think of the old time Miss Budweiser years ago, the alcohol burners. We're right there in that same gambit. We are a lower level as far as professional racers like Langley Speedway. These guys are out there running because they love it. They're not there to run for big prize money, but they're out there because it's in their blood. You cut them, they bleed oil and gas.
Right.
Kind of thing. So
the logistics behind the race, getting involved with the military, the Fort Monroe, the city of Hampton, how much, even Langley to an extent, how much is involved with, because the water is not exactly idle that weekend.
No. Well, actually, you talk about what the extent of involvement. We are involved with probably every facet of government you can think of for getting put in on the event, because we have to file permits with the Coast Guard and federal government, with city as well as state and Fort Monroe authority, because the Army's not really out of Fort Monroe anymore. It is a retired base. But we own the water for Thursday through Monday. So all the oystermen, and because they have oyster cages out there, crabbers, they pull everything out so we can have a safe racing environment. That's the first thing we want to make sure we have for our racers, a safe place to go out and run. We are a record-setting course because we are a protected body of water, and we have it surveyed. So any records that are set, these guys can do it and file it with the APBA, the national organization, and they get points for that at the end of the year. And then race season, that they file for, you know, being a point champion, that kind of thing, just like NASCAR would. They're chasing points. But anyone from 9 years old to me and you could go out there and race, because we actually have smaller boats out there for beginners. We do have a try it before you buy it kind of unique environment for the kids, as well as when you step up to some of our 1 liter boats, the T boats, you can be 14 years old and race those. So you can race them before you drive. And we do see them out there. We do see it quite a bit. And it is a family event on all sides of the water. We have kids come out there since they were babies coming up. Now they're out there with their own kids, as well as the families that are out there racing. They bring their RVs and bring their boats.
Something
and they have
for
time.
Everyone. Tell us about this program you got.
This is our limited edition program. We put it out every year. This is also the same design that goes on our T-shirt. This is where our different sponsors advertise, and our ads are put in, as well as we give a little bit of description of what's going on with that class, what it is, what it looks like, what size motor, engines for those people who are interested in that kind of thing, what kind of fuel it runs. Because we do run everything from regular pump gas you get down here at the gas station to racing fuels like you'd see out cars at Langwood run, to actually alcohol methanol burners. And there's a whole different smell when you see the alcohol burners run by.
How fast do these boats go? And let me ask you this too. The course, how do you measure how long? What is the typical, like, how long?
Well, we are a mile and a quarter oval course. It is survey. We actually nowadays more modern. We use GPS coordinates. We actually set our buoys with the waterway surveys. Folks out from Virginia Beach, like I said, it's surveyed and it's official. Everything is set. All your turns are set. Your out of bounds buoys are set. Everything all by GPS coordinate. We actually they'll come out there starting actually on Thursday and Friday, set the course, and then we're ready to run on Saturday.
Right. Now, people like in NASCAR, they like fast cars, and they like crashes without fatalities. Talk about the good, bad, and ugly there with fast and
we never want to see a crash.
Right.
Never want to see a crash, but as far as speed.
Have you seen a crash?
I'm sorry?
Have you seen crashes?
I have seen crashes. I've seen flips. I've seen bumps to crash.
Fire.
Fire. There has been a few fires. Not at our course, but some of the racers who come out to us. And these are family. They're friends we see racing. It's just not an obscure boat race. And these are people we know.
Mm-hmm.
But as far as speeds go, we see everything from 70 miles an hour up to 150 on a regular basis.
Wow.
Now, we're hoping to bring the Grand Prix back down this year from the Northeast and Canada. Those guys actually get up to 160, sometimes 170, depending on what the conditions are. So you can see some pretty good speeds going.
There's really something for everyone there. Talk about the dates and how people can get involved, because it's free admission.
Free admission. This year, we just have run in August, but this year we are going to move out to September. Cooler weather, less humidity, actually we'll see some better performance with the engines, some better speeds. But being free, you just come out, you can park in Phoebus down North Curry Street. We have a field there, or you can park on the streets or over at Fort Monroe. If you park on Fort Monroe, we do ask you to be courteous to anything that's a reserved spot, because we work very closely with Glenn Oder and those folks out at FMA. They like us because we take care of everything. But just come down there, find your way down to Phoebus. We actually shut down the Mercury Boulevard Bridge end to end. That's our main spectator area. And that actually gives us a unique viewing platform for anybody, because we're actually elevated about 12 feet off the water, and we're parallel to the front straightaway. Just like NASCAR, where you went out with your grandstands, you get a best view at any racing on the East Coast, I always like to say.
Right.
Some people who are putting on other races, they kind of cringe when I say that, but is what it is. Truth is what
right.
it is.
Free admission, Fort Monroe, the oldest continuous running powerboat event in the country, September 23rd and 24th, Hampton Cup Regatta. And you mentioned Mr. Oder, he was a former elected official. His mm-hmm. wife was on the school board here in Newport News at one time. And it's good to have the people like Donnie Tuck, the mayor, and the city council behind you.
Absolutely. We can't say enough good things about anybody who helps support us, especially the council. Billy Hobbs, Donnie Tuck, Linda Curtis, all those folks have been out to see us race. They knew we put on a family-friendly event. I mean, that's one of the first things that Billy's always talked to me about. Over the years, different events have come and gone, and for whatever issues, but we're here to stay. I mean, this is our 92nd race.
Right.
I mean, we've been going since 1926.
Right. It's local on the peninsula, but it's a regional and national event as well.
Yeah, we're recognized nationally as well as regionally. Can't say enough things about that. We've made the national news before with ESPN, different coverage over the years. We always make the local news, daily press, the different networks, always come out and do some B-roll, as they call it, or even interviews out there at the site.
Sure. How many races and how many events per, you have it on 2 days. So
we run
two days. Give us the lay of the land on the first day and the second day.
We will run qualifying heats on Saturday, and then we do the finals on Sunday. Mm-hmm. Typically, we'll run anywhere between 12 and 13 different class of boats, because we actually open it up to all the different classes of the inboard series for APBA. And depending on how many heats we have to run for each class, depending on how many boats show up. And we'll know that usually on Saturday morning, okay, we're gonna run 2-3 heats of each class, and then rerun it on Sunday for the final points for the Hampton Cup.
Right. The equipment, the boats, I'm sure they're expensive to maintain. This is a part-time job for some people. What's the youngest person you've seen and the oldest? And how big is a crew per boat?
Like I mentioned, usually the crew is family, some friends usually. I've seen as few as three people come out to put a boat on the water, including the driver and owner. As a lot of times, the driver and owner are the same person. And then we'll see crews of 12 to 15 come out too.
Right.
Usually with those, they have multiple class boats to run on the team. But as far as cost, just the boat itself without an engine or anything, with some of the bigger ones, can run you $15,000 to $20,000. Mm-hmm. That's why you see a lot of the sponsors come in. And usually the sponsors are local guys, a body shop, a vacation club, that kind of thing. You don't really don't see your Pennzoil or Skoll or those kind of things like you do at NASCAR. These are guys out here, like I said, they're out there doing it because they love it. Sometimes they're out there putting their own money in.
And they put sponsorships on the boats too?
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
Right.
Absolutely. We have multiple sponsorship of opportunities available for anybody who wants to come and sponsor a boat or a class or the race, that kind of thing. HCR1926 at Gmail is the main account. You'd want to mm-hmm. contact us, or we have our website, HamptonCupRegatta.com.
Very good. Let me ask you this too about the Hampton Cup Regatta. You mentioned Hampton. Has it ever been anywhere else besides that Mill Creek area?
We actually started at the Back River. In the Hampton River. Moved the Back River for a little bit. But actually, we started off in the Hampton River right there, right off the, behind the Crown, where the Crown Plaza currently today is. Mm-hmm. That was back in 1926, obviously. And the boats, they moved a little slower back then. Mm-hmm. But as different technologies came up, as World War II came into play, we actually ran test holes for the Navy and the Army during the Hampton Cup. That's one reason why we can say we're the oldest continuously mm-hmm. running, because we never stopped. Some of their events may have started before we did, but they took years off during the war. In post-war years, we actually were getting old airplane engines. Mm-hmm. You had like V-12 engines running some of these boats back then. And that's a very interesting standpoint, from a historical standpoint for me. But as the years went on and power started coming more into it, so certainly as more of the technology developed in a NASCAR and those kind of things, and we put those into it, because these are literally your small block, big block engines, V6, V8, straights, that kind of thing.
Could this ever happen at Buck Row Beach?
Typically not, because one of the things at Mill Creek, we are a protected body of water.
Right.
Wind becomes more of a factor than rain. Mm-hmm. Out of Buckrow, you've always got that constant bay breeze coming down, and that would probably prohibit us from being out of Buckrow. Thing that probably will run a Buckrow is probably more like your drag boats, like you typically see down in Florida and that kind of thing.
Right, but the technology is definitely advanced with these boats.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. You see these things, and they're just screaming across the
How
water.
How fast?
Like I said, up to 160 miles an hour.
Wow.
If you see those guys coming, and really, in the hydroplane part of the boat, when they're racing, when the only thing that's actually touching the water is the prop, because you get that pocket of air under it, and that's what they're made for, and they're riding actually on that pocket of air and coming across.
Are there two people per boat sometimes, or just one always?
One. Typically, your Jersey Speed Skiff, and what I know the class of boat, they actually came to Hampton for the first time last year, because they're typically a West Coast boat, it's called the Cracker Boxes. Mm-hmm. They do have two riders, and I actually got to ride in a Cracker Box last year with our flag lap.
Yeah.
And that was quite the experience.
I mean,
people talk about, oh, I run, you know, 60, 70, maybe 80 miles an hour on the interstate. On the water, it's completely different.
Volunteers and vendors.
We're completely volunteer. Mm-hmm. For the committee, and also when we put on the event, we need our volunteers. We love our volunteers to come out and run everything, help run anything from just safety patrols out on the bridge or spectators, actually getting in the water with the boat crews. I mentioned how small some of these boat crews are, because when they're lifted into the water by the cranes, because these are not trailered in, they actually are lifted off with a big Lockwood crane, and we drop it into the water. You need somebody there to hold the boat in place while the driver gets situated, that kind of thing.
Right. Folks, don't take it for granted. You saw that Langley Speedway left, came back. Bay Days is gone. You never want to take it for granted, even though
absolutely not. We don't take anything for granted year to year. That's why we're always looking to try something different, keep things fresh.
We
had a music component out last year that worked well. We're going to bring that back again this year.
Very good.
But we can't say enough good things about our sponsors, paid sponsors and in-kind sponsors, because we could not put on this event without that.
Absolutely. All right, folks, September 23rd and 24th, 2017, free admission, Fort Monroe. You'll hear more about it as the time goes on. Hampton Cup Regatta since 1926, the oldest running powerboat event in the country. Continuous. Unbelievable. And Craig Cole, thank you so much.
All right,
folks, that was Craig Cole right there from the Hampton Cup Regatta. He is speeding away on the boat right there on the lake as we talk. Great footage as well, courtesy of Craig Cole and his wonderful staff at the Hampton Cup Regatta. Also want to thank Jamie Cox of the Peninsula Track Club. Excellent show for the month of April 2017. For more, log on to NNPSTV.com. As always, thank you to our great students and Ray Price as well. For Ray Price, I'm Greg Bicaveras. Happy April, and we'll talk to you soon. Thank you.